Hello and welcome to the GrapeSEED Official Podcast. On this episode of MeySen Connection, we welcome Brandon Bayron, Candace's husband, from the last MeySen Connection. Welcome to the podcast, Brandon.
Thanks.
How long have you been at MeySen and what is your current role?
I am finishing my fourth year as a Friends Club teacher at Takamori MeySen. Next year, I'm going to be moving to the EX program in Friends Club.
Okay, so just for context for people, Friends Club, quite a bit of different situation than your wife. Your wife's teaching Premier School, so the immersion program, whereas Friends Club is the after-school program for elementary kids to kind of come back to MeySen, take those upper unit GrapeSEED courses, and just continue with the program even after they've left the kindergarten, right?
Yeah.
Can you give us a little bit of context on what EX class is?
So in regular Friends Club, they'll spend time memorizing the pieces and really getting used to just kind of putting the English in their mouth. And then once they have gotten to a sufficient level of fluency with the GrapeSEED pieces, the teachers can start doing more activities where they'll get to use it to express their own ideas. In EX, we meet at a class time kind of staggered with regular Friends Club, and we're one unit behind. So when I have my EX students, they come to me and I start a unit with them. This is the unit that they've just finished in regular Friends Club. So okay, my starting point assumes that they have achieved a higher level of fluency and that we're already ready to start going into usage. So the kids that are in the EX program get a lot more usage and a lot more expression time and just a lot more practice using the English to talk about their ideas and their experiences and their thoughts and things like that. So it's a good continuing development of the foundation that's laid in the regular Friends Club classes.
That's excellent. I love that idea of having a set aside time for kids to basically practice the language that they've used. So this is outside of normal GrapeSEED time, outside of your normal class schedule, but the kids get extra just practice, like you said. So GrapeSEED materials, your favorite one, what do you got?
So my favorite material is going on a bear hunt from Unit 21.
Ooh.
Yeah, when I was in America, I was a camp counselor and camp director for a little while. And this was something that we did with our kids in the States all the time. And it was a lot of fun. And so every time that I've done it here with a class, the class is kind of on their own, come up with a unique way of doing it, like stomping or clapping or sound effects or just something. And it usually happens after they're comfortable with kind of saying the pieces and they get the concept. I've got my one kid in the class who's the class clown who will do something kind of goofy, and the rest of the kids will see me kind of snicker at it. And they're like, oh, okay, we can do this. And then it just kind of evolves into this whole thing. It was really funny to watch a trainee come into my classroom and teach my fourth grade last year and do this piece with them in the corner, because they had no idea what my fourth grade was about to do. And it was like this whole production that they all did in unison. It was really funny. I was just laughing. So it's really fun to do, but there's a lot of language in it. It has to do with choices that syncs up really well with language that they just finished in the prior units. Cause 17 through 20 is a lot of could, should, would, talking about choices and possibilities and things. And so when you get to going on a bear hunt, it provides a context for using some of those things and then provides a springboard for you or for me to make more activities to give them more choices. And so I've done games and like interactive PowerPoints where they've got to make decisions and they've got to talk about what decisions are possible or evaluate what decisions they want to do. Or in the case that they have made an incorrect decision, they've got to talk about something that they must do, which is also in the piece. So it's really easy to pull all that language out and use it for some really fun stuff.
Definitely. I can see how your camp counselor experience in the past really influences your decision here, because this definitely is one of those kind of campfire rhythmic calls and responses. I encourage people, if they haven't listened to this, to go check out on the portal Unit 21's Going on a Bear Hunt and listen for yourself there. How about a favorite unit?
My favorite unit is actually Unit 18. Okay. I really like Unit 18 because one of the things that I do in the units that I can is I try to cross the different GrapeSEED pieces with each other and use one piece to talk about another piece. And Unit 18 is just really, really well suited to do that with all of the different pieces that it's got in it. when the kids are really good at singing the songs and they can do the chants and we're really ready to start using the English to talk about stuff, I can use the different pieces to tell one kind of continued narrative that the kids are going to be able to interact with and talk about. Because I know there's a poem that's called The Bakery. Mm-hmm. And in Marvin Goes to the City, there's a lot of different professions. And one of them is a bakery. And that particular thing shows up again in one of the big books. And then you've got the special song that talks about special. So we talked about different professions and talked about shopping and what different shops have to offer. And talked about some of that could, should, would that's in that unit and the unit prior. And then we get into the special song and start talking about, well, what about some special item? Like if we go into the bakery and we see just like the regular donuts, what kind of special donuts would you like to see or do you see in this context? And so it really puts together in a really cohesive way and makes it really easy to get the feeling that I'm really just teaching one lesson with a lot of different parts.
Goodbye, my friends, goodbye. I'm sad to say goodbye. It was a good day, but now I will say goodbye, my friends, goodbye.
Goodbye, everyone.